As the defense hearing resumed today before Justice Isaac Mwata, the sixth accused person, Sadat Katerega, gave his defense. Court heard that Katerega is a long-time friend to the key suspect, Kopriam Kasolo. In his defense, Katerega, however, denied having been with Kasolo on the day Najirinya and Kitayimbwa were kidnapped and eventually killed. He says he only learned of Najirinya's murder and Kasolo's arrest on TV.
Ngabaga bakutaba abantu aba batanagirinya naye babatute kusaki kati mu mwaka kasera nenda banga bali waka bali na mukusala rugirwe wange
on TV
ku TV
actually you first saw really dealing what you saw on TV you only saw these people breaking into your house
abasirikali aba Kasolo Kompriam beyajja nabo ubali bakola obegulire ebyo balaga nga Kasolo mulese waka wange lening ne batandika okusala oluggi wange oba bali nga balina bakebereyo kuba Kasolo Kompriam yali amaze okugenda okitiibwa omulamuzi.
Although in his charge and caution statement Katerega confessed to having participated in the double murder, Katerega told court that he was tortured by the police officers who demanded that he implicates Kasolo or he would suffer tougher consequences.
Julizi Barasa T. James yayogera wano mu kkooti nti nze Katerega Sadati, Kopriam Kasolo, Seka Hassan, Kalyang Nasifu, omusango guno nga tegunazibwa mbu twagenda ewa Nagirinya ne tukettayo okumanya ebimukwatako. Wakitiibwa omulamuzi, ebintu ebyo si bituufu. Nze n'abantu abo bagamba bategeeza kkooti nti tebamanyi.
After his testimony, the defense team closed their case. Consequently, the matter was adjourned to the 15th of June. Before the adjournment, Kopriam Kasolo, the key suspect, informed court that he had not been assisted by the court registrar. According to Kasolo, the registrar refused to have Kasolo's announcements published in all the local dailies, TVs, and radios.
Nato nafuna nagira nakubaye kirango kimu oba mu new vision nayita abantu owekitiibwa omulamuzi nenda banga tekijja kunkolera kubanga abantu simanyi bawuliriza radio ki tv ki yesobola kino yagala okulanga zonna nga bwe nali nziwadde kkooti kati nembeera nga nfunyemu obuzibu.
Kasolo and his co-accused Johnson Lubega, Nasif Kalyango, Hassan Kiseka, Sharif Mpanga and Sadat Katerega are accused of masterminding and carrying out the kidnap, murder and aggravated robbery against Najirinya and her driver Ronald Kitayimbwa, which happened on 28th August 2019. Still in court, Buganda Road Magistrate Court has adjourned the case against Stanley Kisambira, a driver attached to the judiciary who recently complained of poor salaries. Court presided over by the Chief Magistrate, Gladys Kamasanyo, heard that inquiries into the matter are still on, thus she adjourned the matter to the 11th of July 2023. The 46-year-old judiciary driver is charged with promoting hate speech against judges. Prosecution states that Kisambira on May 12, 2023, within Uganda through a computer, shared on a judiciary transport WhatsApp group information to which the recorded audio, which he was likely to promote hostility against judges in the country. Meanwhile, the International Crimes Division of the High Court has adjourned the hearing of a case against MPs Alan Sewanyana and Muhammad Sejirinya to the 7th of August 2023. This after prosecution failed to respond to an application seeking to hold the ongoing pre-trial sessions until the Constitutional Court decides on whether to merge all the cases against the two legislators. In this application, the two legislators claim they had been tortured while in detention, thus procedures of the High Court should be halted until the application in the Constitutional Court is determined. Sejirinya and Alan Sewanyana are indicted with several counts of murder and terrorism in relation to the 2021 wave of Panga Welding murders. Rachel Nachwala, reporting for the news.